This is the K1967 series temperature alarm in modules. This is set up with five different modules. This is the base module, the K1967-004. This is the alarm module, the K1967-005. This is the inside light module. It's the K1967-006. And this is the panic module, which is basically alarm in case something happens inside the box. And that is the K1967-007. And this is the door sensor, which is the K1967-008. The premise is simple. It's a temperature display. It also has the ability to alarm for high temperature and low temperature. Handles all the functions for panic. It handles the functions for door open timers. So if you leave the door open too long, the alarm will go off. It also handles the lighting features. This one's got a special feature in it. When you turn on the light, you cannot turn it back off on the outside. If you will, this is the outside modules, and these are inside modules. And the door sensor obviously can go on the inside of the box or outside the box. So the only way you can turn off the light, let's say you turned it on, you cannot turn it off here, obviously. The door open sensor doesn't turn it off. The only way you can do it is hitting the inside touch. And that is controlling the full lighting features. So if you're inside the box, nobody can turn off the light, because you're in control of it. The scenario would be if you open the door, which you can see the door sensor does turn on the light, just like touching the button. If you come in, you close the door, you're doing your thing, you want to leave, you open the door and you press the lights off button, and you're ready to go. And that takes care of all the features. Door sensor is not required for the module. If you choose not to use it, you can just put that sensor aside. It does not obstruct anything function-wise. So if you want to turn on the light, you can turn it off here and vice versa. It doesn't have any effect on the whole cycle. You can see there's a couple different things that the alarm module does. It basically has a 100 decibel alarm. So if you hit the panic button, it basically sounds. And also has a display, which gives you an indication of what's going on. If you have the door open, it's going to alternate back and forth, kind of giving you indication there's something going on. Also, the display down here will tell you that the door is open, just in case you don't understand what that means. The door open timer, after a delay, this is set up for a minute, it can be set for 20 minutes, whatever you feel comfortable with. After that, it's going to start beeping. It could be annoying, but it's supposed to be part of the process. If the door is open for a reason, the alarm is set, you can always silence the button by just hitting the up and down arrow, and that'll just silence it so you don't hear the alarm go off anymore. 15 minutes later, the alarm will go off again. And this happens to work for the temperature display alarms too. So let's say you have a situation, you're in the kitchen and you're going through everything, like inventory or something like that, the door is open, it's getting warmer in the box, so after about 20 minutes, it's been warm for a while. The alarm's going to go off, but you know in a couple more minutes you're going to be leaving. It's not the situation. Basically, the situation would be able to, you can silence it. And again, it's only for 15 minutes. It's built in. There's no adjustability for that. So in another 15 minutes, this door alarm will go off again. So you can see it cycles back and forth, but when you hit the panic button, it does more than that. The alarm module will beep with 100 decibels. It also strobes the LEDs. It says a panic, P-A-N, on the display, but it does something else. There's a dialer built in, or a dialer connection built into the alarm module that you can wire into your security system, and it'll aid the security system in dialing out and calling you if there's an issue. I know some of the newer systems actually will send you an email or a text, so you can tie this right into that particular project or alarm system. And again, this was the K1967 series alarm module, and this is pretty much a just a small portion of what this thing can do.